This episode was a very unusual structure to kind of tackle with a show like Revolution, because it played in a sort of It's a Wonderful Life premise of what if none of it ever took place.
Morning.
It's been fun to break this particular story and roll it out slowly to the audience, because Aaron was chosen in episode 201, and the Nanos had a plan for him that's only slowly revealed itself. It had to wait for the sickness to overtake the Nano to the point where they would so desperately try the ultimate Hail Mary pass to get fixed. It just so happens that their Hail Mary pass looks a lot like episode 215. And we got to have a fun ride because the Nano was pulling out all the stops.
I'm not sure any of this is real.
When I read it, I was overwhelmed. I was totally unprepared by everyone's attempts to prepare me. It was just such a cool surprise.
Just let this be real.
It could have been about any character in it, and I would have been like, this is a really bold, awesome departure. The fact that it's about my character is great.
In a lot of ways, this is Aaron's, this is your life. And so everyone who's had an effect on him, good or bad, we had the opportunity to pull that person out of, you know, pull that rabbit out of a hat.
I have, in my opinion, one of the coolest entries and exits ever. I thought that was so rad. And it's so cool to get to do a death scene when you know you're not really dying. And I'm the only character that's still Revolution.
This was a chance to see these characters in a very different way. Like that the blackout as a story that happened to them was pivotal in how we meet them now. And without it, they proceed in a way that we immediately recognize is very different.
All of these snapshots of Miles, of Monroe, of Rachel, they're run through this kind of wild filter that is being presented to Aaron by the Nano.
Nanotechnology, Dr. Matheson, what does this mean in practical terms?
First and foremost, no collateral damage.
The soccer mom, but the soccer mom who basically just, you know, took out seven, you know, Taliban strongholds, this like genius who everything came together for, and she's like, yes, I have actually brought peace to Earth. But you know, that happens. Like it was kind of complete wish fulfillment. It was fantastic. We were having the best time because everybody was completely different.
There's a scene in the where everybody ends up in this motel room. Miles is just kind of a dopey, you know, drunk living in a seedy motel, and Liz is a buttoned up soccer mom, and then Dave just bursts through the door with like a six pack and a pizza.
Oh, what the hell is all this, huh?
And it was like in my head I just heard that sitcom soundtrack where like the audience applauds when the Fonz comes in, and I started laughing and I blew the take.
All right, enough.
Aaron's journey is one where he has to shock them out of that state to get back to the post-blackout versions that we know.
I need you to be who I need you to be, so be it, be you.
You can see those actors just sinking their teeth into it and having an absolute blast.
He's an interesting cat.
I think the ability to play that kind of alternate character is just incredibly fun. You can sink your teeth into it in a way that you can't with a character as it evolves throughout two seasons, because this is a parallel universe.
You need to fix that coat. You can't do anything to me.
We are consistently impressed with and inspired by the work that this whole cast does with all of their roles. And I don't think we would have served up 215 on a platter for him if there was any doubt that Zach could pull it off.
I'm not afraid of you anymore.
Zach struck me when I watched the first season as one of the characters who is really doing a lot of our humanizing. Like in the very first episode, he's talking about his own problems with the blackout. He made it very personal and very real.
$80 million in the bank, and I would trade it all right now for a roll of Charmin.
At the core of this particular episode that was going to have a lot of really whacked out stuff going on, it really just helped to know that he was going to be there at the center of it and right toward that.
Thank you, Mr. Pittman, for fixing us.
When you get to the end of this episode, heartbreakingly, it looks like the Nano has won. And what that means is all the changing they've done and all the evolving the Nano has done over the course of the season, they're nowhere close to being through. From the resurrection to the fire starting.
Rise and shine, Aaron.
to now this crazy trip through the looking glass, we can promise that it's not done with Aaron just yet.